stuff right now. Uncle Artie's gonna show you how. Grab some paper, a pencil or pen. Maybe a beverage. We're about to begin.
Oh, that's looking good, Ray. You're getting good. It looks like a big pile of burnt hair. Friends, how long's it been since you picked up a pencil and drew something? Well, that's too long. Why don't you get a pencil right now, the original drawing app, and a piece of paper. You get a pen or a crayon, it doesn't matter, anything you can draw with. Let's draw some stuff that goes fast. Things like a motorcycle, maybe a hot rod, a fast boat, maybe an airplane. Airplanes go fast and they can fly too. You might also want to get something to drink, because when you're drawing fast stuff, your throat tends to get a little parched. And it's fun to drink and draw. If you're ready, I'm ready. Let's draw. Let's start with a motorcycle. Now, first we do the front wheel. Now, a wheel is a circle, but because this one's kind of coming at us, I'm going to make it an oval. And notice I'm leaving a big gap on one side. That's so that I've got a place to put the thing that holds the wheel onto the motorcycle. They call that the front fork, for some reason. There's an axle, and the inside of the rim. What do you think, Ray? Shall I do a fender? Yeah. Put a few tire treads on there, give it some shape. Okay, I think I'll do the headlight. Maybe a couple of turn signals on either side of that. Give them some shape. Put a spring right there. It's actually a shock, which is just a funny word for a spring. Now the handlebar, I'm going to start with the outside handlebar that's coming at us. So you put a little oval there and then bring it around and connect it up to the front fork. Then I'll put the grip on there and the brake lever. Now the other handlebar is going away from us, so you don't see the end of it. And then the clutch lever, which looks just like a brake lever. My motorcycle got two big wheels. I ride 'cause I like the way it feels. I ain't lying. When I drive around, it's like flying. But I'm on the ground. I think I'm gonna draw the motor. This one's a V-twin, so I'm drawing the front cylinder. You just make all these little lines here. And I'll do the back cylinder. Things on top of the motor like that. I don't even know what those are. Okay, I'm gonna do the tailpipe. This starts, it comes off the front cylinder, and then it's gonna go all along the whole side of the motorcycle, so you have to do it first because it goes on the outside. All the way back. And that's the transmission. Here's a peg for the guy to put his foot on. Battery box. Let's put the seat on there. We probably ought to make that seat black. What do you think, Ray? Okay. Now, before I do the back wheel, I'm going to do the thing that holds the back wheel on. This is how the motor sends power to the back wheel. It's the frame. Now, I can go ahead and shape in the back wheel. Side of the rim. I think we need a back fender and a tail light. Yeah. There's some reflection in the chrome of the tailpipe. Look at that. Do a little shading here. Make those tires gray. A little shadow under the tank. Fill it in a little bit. What do you think it needs, Ray? A kickstand? Okay. There we go. Probably need a little shadow under the wheels just so you know it's sitting on the ground.
And then for a final touch, we need a grease spot right here under the motor. And the way you know it's a grease spot, you put these little lines in it to show that it's shiny. Yeah. All right. I don't know. What else should I do on this? Maybe some more treads on the tire? Give it a little more shape? All right. I think I'll sign it. Oh, you know what? I should color in those hand grips. There, that's better. Now it's done. All right, we're gonna draw a hot Chevy. I'm gonna start with the headlights. Give you an idea what direction the car's going. So it's kind of coming at us a little bit so we can see both headlights. Little emblem in the front of the hood. Now I'm gonna outline where the grill goes. When Uncle Arty draws a car, it usually comes out looking kind of like a 57 Corvette, but you can draw any kind of car you want. I like to make it look like he's got teeth for a grill. But you know, you can put anything you want in that grill. Design your own car. And there's the front of the hood. And to make the hood go up kind of high, like the motor's so big it's pushing it up. Spot for the front wheel. When the car's on the move, I like to make the wheels sort of distorted, like the car's getting out ahead of them a little bit. To the inside of the rim, there's the hub, a couple of lug nuts maybe. And it's always dark under the wheel well, so put a shadow in there. Make the wheel in the background gray, but don't go completely black, because it'll make it look further away if it's not. Some kind of design on the side of the car. And then when I draw the back wheel, I like to make it go down a little lower than the front wheel, almost like it's a horse rearing up. Well, down by the water, I like to cruise along the levee with the farmer's daughter in my red hot Chevy.
Cruise along the levee.
I like to cruise along the levee
in my red hot Chevy.
In my red hot Chevy.
Cruise along the levee in my red hot Chevy.
Let's put a tailpipe in there in the back bumper. Maybe some puffy little clouds coming out of the tailpipe. This is the way my dad used to draw smoke coming out of the exhaust pipe. Makes a car look like it's moving. The guy driving this car is a bird. Funny looking little bird with sunglasses on. Of course, you gotta wear sunglasses if you got the top down. I think I'll make it a blackbird. And that works well because we can make it look like the feathers are blowing in the wind. The illusion of speed. The birds don't really have fingers. Sorry, Ray. But we can make the wing feathers come up and look sort of like fingers. And that's how he holds onto the steering wheel. Looks like he's driving. Maybe a little color in the beak. Now we can put in the windshield. Since we know where the driver's sitting. Yeah. Let's shade in the tires. You know, one thing Uncle Artie's found is if you're trying to make it look like it's going fast, make your shading lines go the direction the thing is going. These are action lines right here. And then let's just put some horizontal lines coming off of the tires. That's working. Make it look like he's really going fast. You put a shadow under the car, but always have the car out in front of the shadow a little bit. It's kind of like the shadow can't catch up with the car. He's going so fast. All right. A little more shading. And then we need some tire tread on the front of the tires. And then the lower part of the car is always going to be a little darker than the top of the car. So let's shade that in, give it a little contour. Keep those lines going in the direction you're heading. Yeah, big old dust cloud in the back always helps. And he's driving down by the water, so we need some seagulls. Maybe one more. Yeah. All right, man, I'll tell you what, drawing all this fast stuff's making old Uncle Arty kind of thirsty. I think I'll take a little drink. Not you, though. You've had your limit. Mmm, man, that's good. Let's draw a boat.
I always like to start with the bow of the boat. That's the pointy end. That way you know which way the boat's going. And then I think I'll draw an outboard motor on the back. And the shaft coming down. And the prop makes a bunch of funny little waves going out behind the boat. I think I'll make Uncle Arty drive in this boat. Put his glasses on there. Give him a hat. And then he needs a chin. Shoulder, maybe an ear. Let's make some hair going out the back. There you go. That way you know he's going fast. He's got a little windshield and a little steering wheel. We'll put his hand on the steering wheel. There we go. That looks pretty good. Okay, we need somebody out in the front of the boat keeping a lookout. Maybe we need a funny looking black bird. And he's got to have sunglasses on because he's out on the boat. And that gives us an opportunity to make him look like he's going fast because his feathers are flying back. Yeah, I think he needs a wing feather. There's a wing. Give him a tail feather flying back. There you go. He's keeping a lookout. He's watching for obstacles. Okay, a big old bow wake. That's the water when it splashes up in the front of the boat. Now here we go.
When you're out on the sea, a good way to float. You stick with me in my trusty boat. We'll laugh and grin and splash around. But don't fall in, cause you just might drown. Stay in the boat.
Stay in the boat.
You got to stay in the boat.
Stay in the boat.
You got to stay in the boat.
There's some clouds. Then we need some action lines. Make it look like he's going fast. Just like everything else. Put a little shading at the bottom of the boat. Make it look like it's a wooden boat. Yeah, it looks like it's going fast. Okay, I'll clean this one up a little later. I'm gonna go ahead and sign it. All right, I'm gonna draw a plane. Start with the nose. They call it the nose. And then I gotta draw the front edge of the wing because that breaks the line of the bottom of the plane there. That way you know where you're going. Draw the end of it so you can see it's thick. Get the whole shape of the plane drawn in here. There's the tail wing. And that's got the rudder on the back of it, just like a boat. wings. There you go.
Ooh.
All right, let's make the prop. So he's flying, so the prop is moving, so it's a blur. There you go. A little shading underneath. Okay, I think the pilot on this plane should be a little pig. So I'm going to start with the nose, put a couple of nostrils in there.
Oh.
And then maybe we'll put the goggles on him because he's a pilot. You always have to wear eye protection when you're flying an open plane, kids. Top of his head, maybe some little pig ears flying back there. And then I think he needs a scarf. Yeah, that way we can see he's going fast because it's flying back. There's his shoulder, the back of his seat. Now, pigs don't have hands, they have hoofs, so you kind of got to curve his hoof around the steering wheel so it looks like he's steering. But that works. Need to make him smiling more. There you go. Yeah, I like to fly in my plane above the clouds, above the rain. I can go real far, I can go real fast, but I gotta come down before I'm out of gas. I like to fly way up high in the sky. Yeah, I'm gonna draw it from above now. Start with the top of the little pig's head. There's his little nose. Get his scarf flying back behind him. And you got his little arms coming around holding onto the steering wheel.
Ooh.
Okay, now we draw the outside of the middle of the plane. That's called the fuselage. Don't ask me why. There's the tail wings. Draw the wings from up above.
Ooh.
Gotta have that prop. The prop looks the same no matter what direction you're looking at it from. The nice thing about drawing it from above is you can ride on the wing. I think I'm gonna put pig air. Uncle Artie's just about out of lead. Look at that. There's nothing left on his pencil. Maybe I got enough to do a few more action lines here. That'll do it. I'd say this one's done.
Yeah. You're getting good. It's looking good. You know, if Uncle Artie could give you just a little advice, sometimes I like to say it's just as important what you leave out as what you put in. Hey folks, I think we're just about out of time. Thanks for joining us and drawing with us today. You know, if you want Uncle Artie to see what you've been drawing, you might want to have mom or dad or whatever parental figure you got hanging around the house take a picture of it with their phone or their digital camera and attach it to an email and send it to UncleArtie@loudville.tv. Don't let Uncle Eddie take the picture. And also, if you have an idea of something you'd like Uncle Artie to draw for you, send that to us. All right, kids, keep drawing. Because the more you draw, the more drawings you got. See you later.